Good morning, students. Today we are going to demonstrate the first experiment, that is pollen germination. So the aim of this experiment is to study pollen germination on a temporary slide which you have to prepare.
So the materials required are water, sucrose. We have to prepare the nutrient solution. For that we take 20 grams of sucrose and dissolve it in 100 ml of water. So this is the freshly prepared nutrient solution, so dropper. Then we use two flasks, one balsam, the other one vinca rosa. Now cover slip, cavity slide, blade, brush, filter paper and microscope.
Now how to take the pollen grains? The pollen grains must be taken. Before that, first take the cavity slide and put one drop of nutrient solution on both the cavities inside. So this cavity slide has an advantage. Your pollen grains will not move out of position. Okay, in an ordinary slide it will be flowing here and there. Cavity slide, you put a drop of nutrient medium in the depression seen on the slide, it will remain there. So this is a cavity slide. We have put a drop of nutrient medium in the two depressions seen on the slide. Next, for vinca rosa, how do we take the anther or the pollen grains? For that, see here, in vinca rosa, you should remember the stamens, the anther with the anthers are present at the corolla tube. Just below the petals, there's a small enlargement, that is the corolla tube. The neck of the corolla tube, you can see the stamens with the anther lobes. So either by using a blade or a needle, make a small cut on that corolla tube, the neck region, very close to the petal, and expose the anthers. You can see an arrowhead. The arrowhead is the anther lobes which contain the pollen grains. That anther, you can take it out by the needle and you can dust it onto the cavity slide you have prepared with a nutrient medium. Okay. Your anther lobe. So these are the anther lobes. Gently press on it with the help of the needle. The pollen grains will come out of the anther lobes. Once they come out of it, you have to remove this anther lobes. It has to be moved away so that your slide will contain only the pollen grains. So if your flower is vinca rosa, then this is how you will expose the pollen grains onto the cavity slide. Now if you are having balsam, in that case it is much more simpler. Take a cavity slide again, put a drop of nutrient medium onto it, the cavities, yes, put a drop of nutrient medium into the cavities. Here the anthers are exposed, just simply dust on it, just press on it. The pollen grains will come onto the nutrient medium. Then keep it aside for 10 to 20 minutes so that it takes time for the pollen tube to come out. At that time, take a cover slip by using a needle. Place the cover slip on this slide using a needle. Gently place the cover slip over this cavity. Right? So you have prepared the slide. You're keeping it aside for 20 minutes. Okay. After 20 minutes, the pollen grains will start germinating. Then you have to take the microscope, adjust the low power of the microscope, place your slide beneath the objective lens and looking through it, adjust it till you see the pollen grains with the pollen tube coming out of it. Right. So you can see that very clearly. You can see the pollen tube will be a faint color tube is coming out from the pollen grains.
Now look at the board, children. You can see the pollen grains before germination. So look at the pollen grain closely. You can see this is the inner layer in time and the outer layer exine. Now there are germ pores present on the exine. What are germ pores? So just recall what you have learned in theory. The part where sporopollenin is absent on the exine, Those gaps are called germ pores. Now look at this diagram. The pollen grains after germination. See, through the germ pore, the pollen tube has emerged out. Now this is an enlarged view of the germinated pollen grain. So outer layer exime, inner layer intyme, and the pollen tube. So look at the outer layer of the pollen tube. This is the intyme. Now the generative cell has divided into two male gametes, and you can see the male gametes have descended into the pollen tube. Okay, so you have to draw the diagrams neatly in your record. Thank you, children.